I'm not saying this is what the Titans are doing, but there is a way that Jon Robinson can use this to his benefit. Paul, we've got Titans and Bears this weekend here in Music City. COVID protocol has been a big point of discussion all week, as Mike Vrabel, you spoke with him yesterday, as the local media did on the Zoom chat. He remains in protocol. There are others with the team, including Ryan Tannehill, who, as of right now, remain in protocol. All of these players vaccinated and coaches can test out within a 48-hour period if they have two straight negative tests in that 48-hour block. So far, we have not seen that happen.
No. I don't know why I'm a bit surprised, because you hear minimal symptoms. But if you don't get those two negative tests within 48 hours, you're out after 10 days. After 10 days, you're considered non-contagious. So nobody's going to be out longer than 10 days. So Ryan Tannehill's not in any danger long-term for this team. And there's a bye week now built in what would have been week four in the preseason. So anybody that's out right now, the biggest being Tannehill and Harold Landry, these guys, even if they continue to test positive, will be fine on a timeline to be practicing for the full week for Arizona to get ready for the opener, conditioning and all of that. Will be fine, as will Mike Vrabel.
Final cutdown day is when?
Tuesday.
Next Tuesday?
Yes.
So, believe it or not, here's my theory on the testing out process. Maybe Ryan Tannehill's wasn't going to play any snaps at all on Saturday, tomorrow. I keep having to remind myself it's Friday and the game's tomorrow. I'm not saying this is what the Titans are doing, but there is a way that Jon Robinson can use this to his benefit. He has players currently that are not counted against his 53-man roster that are on the COVID-19 reserve list. We know Ryan Tannehill and Harold Landry and Jeff Swaim are going to be on the main roster. They're currently on the COVID-19 reserve list. If I'm a general manager, any general manager, right now, and I have a player who is currently in a 10-day COVID protocol, I'm going to leave them there past the cutdown day, because I can keep an extra receiver for the 53-man roster while all these other teams gobble up and sign and claim released players. I can then waive when Tannehill comes back to the active roster. Let's hypothetically say it's Chester Rogers or Nick Westbrook-Akina that it's coming down to at wide receiver. And I think Rogers is on the roster, but go with me here. I just pulled two names. You're going to release one of them in this scenario. You can keep both while all the other teams make their decisions on practice squad and who they're cutting and releasing and who they're claiming and who they're bringing in. You can keep them around where they cannot be claimed. And then you try to sneak them through to a practice squad after all the other teams have made their decisions. There's a way to use this to your benefit if you're the Tennessee Titans. And maybe that's why you're not rushing the 48-hour period if you have a couple of players who you know are going to be ready for week one, who you're not really wanting to see anyway against Chicago. Why rush it? Use it.
You're correct, but I don't think he has any control over using it. I think everybody's tested every day, and if you get two negatives within 48 hours, you're activated. So they can root for the right results, like you're talking about. Like, a slow return for a certain guy would be beneficial for them,
yes,
roster-wise, in terms of what you're saying, because you're absolutely right. The longer you can defer some of these decisions, the more other teams go about their business and the less likely you are to shuffle things Thursday, Friday, Saturday next week than you are Tuesday. But they don't have a lot of control. Chester Rogers, by the way, and I mentioned this the other day, Marcus Johnson too, are vested. So they don't go through waivers, and you could manipulate it this way, which a Twitter guy recommended, Nick Lombardi, I think. You could just say to Marcus Johnson or Chester Rogers, hey, I'm going to cut you today to manipulate the roster, re-sign you tomorrow, because I need to keep somebody on the 53 that I'm then going to IR tomorrow to buy myself 3 weeks. So let's just make a deal here. I'll re-sign you tomorrow. Maybe I'll give you a little extra money on the side, or maybe you and your agent are just doing us a favor in good faith. But this is a way for me to get you on the roster Not on the initial 53, but on the 53 a day after the initial 53, where I can IR somebody that I had to keep on the initial 53.
Right, but it may also save the Titans money structurally if you don't have to guarantee, if a guy's contract's locked in for the week one roster, you cut them loose and then re-sign them where they're on a week-to-week basis where nothing's guaranteed as a vested veteran. I mean, it would save them money long-term.
That's actually about being on the roster the first Sunday. So if you're on the roster the first game, your vested contract then guarantees for the season. So if you did that with somebody that wasn't on the roster for the Arizona game and then brought him back the Monday after, yeah, then that would be cheaper. Yeah, Thicken goes to hell and you bring in Gostkowski, you're paying him week to week, and then if he goes to hell, you're not on the hook for the rest of his salary. That
makes a lot of sense.
That's a savings route.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified every time Outkick 360 goes live. We are live weekdays, 11 a.m. Central, noon Eastern, right here across the Outkick Network. And while you're at it, like this video and let us know what you think in the comments below.